Welcome, Summer Battle of the Books, teams and families. The University of Miami Hurricanes are thrilled to have you and to kick off your summer reading adventure. I'm Tamara Brown and I will be your host today. Get ready for an action-packed event with important book battle information, special Hurricanes guests, and even some opportunities to show off your dance moves. If you have any questions along the way, please submit them in the question box located on the bottom of your screen. We would like to thank all of you for joining us this morning. Before we get started, we would like to thank all of the organizations that have made the 2020 book battle come to life. Miami-Dade Grade Level Reading Campaign, the Children's Trust of Miami-Dade, Florida International University Center for Children and Families, Reading Explorers, Nova Southeastern University Project RISE, Miami-Dade Public Library System, Miami-Dade Public School System, National Black Child Development Institute, Liberty City Reads Fest, Miami-Dade College School of Education, and Miami-Dade Family Learning Partnership. Thank you again to all of the organizations who have made the 2020 Battle of the Books possible. Let's jump right in with our first guest, Danielle Barreras from the Children's Trust. Danielle, thank you for joining us.
Hi, Tamara. Thank you for having me.
Why don't you tell everyone a little bit about the Battle of the Books this summer?
Thank you, I will. So I am so happy that all of you are joining us, all the kiddos out there in Miami-Dade. We know that reading gives you superpowers. And so what I'd like to do is share with you a really exciting site that I'm going to ask all of you as soon as this is over to go and check out on your own. Look here, it's the Battle of the Books on stayhome.miami. And don't worry, I don't expect you to remember all that. I'll put it in the chat so that you can click on that link whenever you're ready. So the countdown for today's launch party was right there and we are on it. We click on learn more and look at those kiddos and what are they holding? They're holding the three books, one for kindergarten first, one for second and third, and one for fourth and fifth. So all you kiddos out there that are within kindergarten through fifth grade have a book that you can read this summer. And how are you gonna get that book? Don't worry, because right here on this site has everything you need. Step one, you can register for your e-card for the library. If you don't have a library card, that's where you're gonna be able to get one. And then here, step two, you have your three books. And then not only do you have the books, but then you have a way to download them so you don't have to pay for any of the books. You can download them right to the computer or the phone that you're on right now. And you're gonna read those exciting books. And then maybe you and grandma or you and aunt or daddy are going to do some of the fun activities that go along with that book. And you're gonna click right here on these links and have all these fun activities to do with your books. And then step three, you've gotta register for the biggest battle of the summer. And it's our Battle of the Books on July 9th from 10 to 12. This is your chance to win prizes, maybe a pizza party right to your house or right to your camp. It could be that you're going to get a voucher so that you can go to one of Miami Hurricanes athletics events. Or it could be that you become the next great book warrior and are crowned as the Battle of the Books champion. So we hope that you'll check out stayhome.miami and that you'll do all these steps, read your books, and have a great summer. And then we'll see you on July 9th. I'll stop sharing. Thank you, Tamara. I hope that gave lots of information for all the families joining us.
It sounds like this Battle of the Books will be even better than last year. Thank you, Danielle. Now let's have some fun with one of my favorite games, the Sebastian Shuffle. Watch the video carefully and see if you can guess correctly. Which Sebastian has the football? That's right, number two. Now we have a very special video message from our head baseball coach, Gino Damari.
To help launch Sebastian's. My daughters are going to talk about why reading is important to them, starting with Nicolette.
Reading gives me knowledge and enhances my vocabulary.
Gianna.
Reading inspires me.
Giselle.
Reading relaxes me and this is my favorite book.
Gina.
Reading makes me smile and this is my favorite book.
Reading helps, I think, develop the brain and energize the brain, and we want to wish you the best of luck. And on behalf of my family, have a great summer.
Wow, it's great to see Coach Damari and his family share their love for reading. Now I need all of you to get up on your feet and show me your dance moves. Follow along with our Hurricanes dance team, the Sensations. Some great dance moves. Now I am very excited to introduce our very special guest from the University of Miami, Bree Jackson women's basketball and Gannon Feldman football. These two talented student athletes are so excited to talk to you about reading. If you have any questions for Bree or Gannon, you can send us a message in the chat box. Let's get started with Bree. Hi Bree, thank you so much for joining us today. Tell us a little bit more about you, and I also hear you have a book to read to us.
Hi, my name is Bree Jackson. I play for the University of Miami women's basketball team. I am now a sophomore, and I am from the hometown of Virginia Beach, Virginia. The book I'm reading for everyone today is If You Give a Mouse a Cookie. If you give a mouse a cookie, he's going to ask for a glass of milk. When you give him the milk, he probably asks for a straw. When he's finished, he'll probably ask for a napkin. Then he'll want to look in a mirror to make sure he doesn't have a milk mustache. When he looks in a mirror, he might notice he needs a trim. So he'll probably ask for a pair of nail scissors. When he's finished giving himself a trim, he'll want a broom to sweep up. He'll start sweeping, and he might get carried away and sweep every room in the house. He may even end up washing the floors as well. When he's done, he'll probably want to take a nap. You'll have to fix up a little box for him with a blanket and a pillow. He'll crawl in, make himself comfortable, and fluff the pillow a few times. He'll probably ask you to read him a story. So you'll read to him from one of your books, and he'll ask to see the pictures. When he looks at the pictures, he'll get so excited, he'll want to draw one of his own. He'll ask for paper and crayons. He'll draw a picture. When the picture is finished, he'll want to sign his name with a pen. Then he'll want to hang his picture on your refrigerator, which means he'll need scotch tape. He'll hang up his drawing and stand back to look at it. Looking at the refrigerator will remind him that he's thirsty. So he'll ask for a glass of milk. And chances are, if he asks for a glass of milk, He'll want a cookie to go with it. And that is if you give a mouse a cookie. This book, actually, my mom used to read to me when I was younger. That's why this is my favorite book. Back to you, Tamara.
Thank you, Bree. It's so funny. You're from Virginia Beach, Virginia. I'm from Newport News. So, hi. We share that in common. Thank you so much for sharing this awesome book with us. That is also a book that my mom used to read to me when I was a kid. Now let's hear from Gannon. Gannon, we are excited to have you today. Tell us about yourself and how reading has helped you in your football career.
Thank you, Tamara. Hi, everyone. I'm Gannon Feldman. I'm a sophomore. I play with Miami football, and I'm a safety for them. And I'm from Danville, Pennsylvania, a little central town in the woods of Pennsylvania. So I'm happy to be here, and thank you for having me. For me, reading was always a good way for me to take a step back from football after I get tired after practice or whatever. It's always easy enough to just sort of lay down and unwind and open up a good book, you know. Unfortunately, I don't have it with me, but I wanted to talk about my favorite book a little bit that I read when I was in, you know, middle school or elementary school. And that was, it's called The Million Dollar Throw by Mike Lupica. And it details a story about a young kid named Nate Brody, who is nicknamed Brady because he's a really good quarterback for his middle school team in New England. And for everyone that knows anything about football in New England, you know the name Tom Brady, right? So he's him being a good quarterback for his peewee team, everybody named him Brady. And the story goes, he started to get his confidence rattled a little bit, and he wasn't performing as well as he wanted to. And there was a moment where he saved up enough money to go to a Patriots game and even got himself a signed football by Tom Brady. And at halftime, for everyone that watches, you know, college sports and pro sports and everything, a lot of times teams like to do those halftime events where they do something fun with one of the fans at halftime for a chance to win some money and that sort of fun thing. And he had an opportunity to make a throw through a hoop at halftime to win $1 million. So he was always unsure of himself of, you know, as of late, you know, how well he could perform. And at halftime, he had an opportunity to go win a whole bunch of money at a Patriots game. And I won't spoil it for you in case you want to read it. But it for me, it was a book that spoke a lot about, you know, confidence and being able to do whatever you set your mind to. So for me, it was always a goal to get to this school and play football here. And, you know, that book was part of where I found some of my confidence to do that. So for me, that's why reading was always very important for me and why it still is. You know, I just want to thank Tamara and Emily and everyone that organized this event, and thank you for having me on. Back to you, Tamara.
Thank you, Gannon, for sharing that story with us. You mentioned that that book gave you the confidence to, you know, get into school and be where you are today. How did reading help you get into college and become the student athlete that you are today?
Well, reading was always very important for me in school. That was something that I struggled with academically a little bit more. I was always a little bit better at the maths and sciences just naturally. So I knew for, you know, from a test score perspective, I needed to boost my English and reading and stuff. So, you know, I never had the most fun reading stories in English class, and I wasn't that good at it. But the more I read outside of class and the more I read about what I was actually genuinely interested in, the easier it became to perform well in school. So that was the big thing for me, as well as in terms of football. Like I said, with that book that I just talked about, there's a lot of books out there, fiction, nonfiction, that can provide good themes and takeaways for you in life, you know, that you can translate to your own situations, you know? So for me, that book gave me confidence to keep working hard and try to get where I wanted to be in football.
Thank you so much for just being so vulnerable and honest today and sharing those thoughts with us.
Thank you so much for having me.
Bree, we've got a question for you from the audience. What books did you like to read as a child, and why does reading help us become great? How does reading help us become better students and hopefully student athletes in the future as well?
As a kid, I actually liked reading this series called Jimmy B. Jones. It was like the first chapter books I would read, and I just loved reading all her books. And reading helps you become a better student and student athlete, just because without reading, you can't really get through any subjects in school. And with becoming a student athlete, I can read the plays that my coach gives me. So that's how reading helps.
Thank you so much, Bree. It was so great to hear from Bree and Gannon today. I can't wait to take some time to read this weekend. Now let's all stand again and join Sebastian for a quick dance party.
Peanut butter jelly time, peanut butter jelly time. Way back, way back, way back, way back. There you go, there you go, there you go, there you go. Peanut butter jelly, peanut butter jelly, peanut butter jelly, peanut butter jelly. Peanut butter jelly, peanut butter jelly, peanut butter jelly with a baseball bat.
While Sebastian couldn't join us today, he wanted to let you all know how proud he is that you will be taking part in the book battle and reading this summer. Now we will hear from Anna Rondon of FIU's Reading Explorer. Thank you for joining us today.
Thank you so much, Tamara, for that wonderful introduction. And thank you all for joining us here today. We're so excited to have kiddos and families and camps all tuning in with us today. We've got some great information to share with you about this upcoming book battle. And we also, you know, as you've seen, have some really fun and exciting dance moves and stories being shared with our panelists here. So one of the things I wanted to mention are if you're a child and if you're going to camp this summer, so if you're actually going to camp or if you're logging in from your home, you will be able to join us on this virtual book battle. And me and my team from Reading Explorers, we actually went out to several camps yesterday and we dropped off hard copies of books. And we are getting things ready to send your way to pair with those books. So be on the lookout from your camp for more instructions about how this battle is going to come to life. But we are going to see you on July 9th, and it's going to be such a fun time. We're just so looking for an awesome event. You'll hear more information about what the event's gonna have from the next great guest. But one of the things that we will be doing is we'll have Kahoot for you during that battle. And that's gonna be how you're gonna answer all the questions during the battle. And in addition, you'll be getting some goodie bags if you haven't already got them yet that have the book inside if you're going to a camp. As one of our guests mentioned earlier, if you're gonna be joining the battle home, you can actually access the books from the awesome stayhome.miami website. So I'm gonna see if I can share my screen and show that site one more time. All right, so hopefully you can see my screen now. And as you'll notice that there is awesome information about the countdown here, as well as learn more. As well as information about how to access the books. So here's how you access your books if you're tuning in from home, or if you're going to camp virtually. So if you go to your camp and you are doing this through computer, then this might be how you access your books. And these are the three books that we've picked this summer for our battle. And then there will be some more activities that'll be posted here that camps can use and that you can use as a parent or as a, if you wanna go on and find out how to learn more and do more, I encourage you to visit this site, and we make sure you can see this site on your chat box as well. All right. Well, thank you guys so much for joining us today. And we really can't wait to see you on July 9th. We'll be looking forward to keeping in touch. Thanks, Tamara, for the introduction and for hosting us through this awesome event. Back to you.
And thank you, Anna, for sharing a lot of very important information for our participants. Before we hear from our last guest, let's do one more dance with the sensations. Getting up and moving with us. Let's hear from our final guest, Latoya Hopwood of Nova Southeastern University. She is the Battle of the Books MC. Welcome, Latoya.
Hi, everybody. Welcome, kids at home, families, campers, all my children trust providers. Hi, hi, hi. I just want to let you know that I will be hosting this year's book battle again, and it's going to be so, so, so exciting. Remember, it's July 9th from 10 to 12. We are going to have two book battles, one for our second and third graders, the same way we did last year, one for our fourth and fifth graders. You can register, and it will be on Zoom. Please, 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 please familiarize yourself with Kahoot, because that's how I will be asking your questions. So I don't want anybody to be startled or like, I don't really know this site. Make sure you familiarize yourself with Kahoot. Make sure you have Zoom, which you probably do if you're watching now. And if you need any help with understanding your books, reading your books, Ms. Toya, I don't even know what this word means, have your site director to email me. Everybody has my email. Have them to email me, and I will be more than happy to help you. I cannot wait to host this book battle. Happy reading, everyone. Back to you, Tamara.
Thank you, Latoya, Anna, and Danielle for joining us today and working so hard behind the scenes to get the book battle ready for all of our wonderful readers. And thank you again to our special guests, Bree and Gannon. Before we go, I have one more video from a very special University of Miami football coach and his family.
Hello, Summer Book Battle teams. I'm offensive coordinator Rhett Lashley, the Miami Hurricanes. I'm here with my four kids.
Hi, my name's Hudson.
What's your name, sweetheart?
Scarlett. My name's Thomas.
Hey, babe, what's your name?
My name is Rowan.
That's Rowan. Now, we're here today to tell you about some of our favorite books. So, Hudson, why don't you go first?
I like Maple Ridge because it's full of, like, adventures.
Hudson likes reading adventure books. Scarlett, what's your book about colors? Do you like colors, baby? She does. She likes colors, Thomas.
I like numbers.
Okay, Rowan, she loves reading about numbers, don't you, baby? All right, Thomas, tell us about your book.
I like the Who Was series because it tells information about famous people.
And what's great is, you know, the girls are only 4 years old, so they can read small books about colors and numbers, and that helps them learn. At the same time, the boys can read a little bit harder books, and that helps them learn. just learning is something that happens when you read books. We're really excited that y'all are part of this book battle. I want to wish you the best of luck this summer in the book battles. Really excited to have you as a part of the Sebastian's Reading Squad this summer, and hope y'all come out this fall and support us at some Hurricane games. Go Canes!
As Coach said, on behalf of Sebastian and the University of Miami Athletic Department, best of luck prepping for the 2020 Summer Battle of the Books. Stay safe, stay healthy, and keep reading.